Hello everybody, welcome to judicecentral.com online classes for law exams. So today I will be discussing with you the current affairs on awards, appointments, sports and entertainment for the year 2020 to 2021. So let us start. So I'll start with Nobel Prize 2020. This is physiology and medicine. The Nobel Prize has been awarded to American medical researchers and virologists Harvey J. Alter and Charles M. Rice and British scientist Michael Houghton for the discovery of hepatitis C, which was discovered in 1982 by screening millions of DNA samples. Then physics, the Nobel Prize in Physics for the year 2020 was awarded to three astrophysicists, Roger Penrose from the UK, Reinhard Genzel from Germany and Andrea Ghez from the USA. Roger Penrose received half of this year's prize for the discovery that a black hole formation is a robust prediction of the general theory of relativity, and the second half has been received by Genzel and Ghez for the discovery of a supermassive black hole at the center of the Milky Way galaxy, now known to be the Sagittarius A. Now we will deal with chemistry. Emmanuel Carpentier of France and Jennifer Doudna of the USA have been awarded the 2020 Nobel Prize in Chemistry for declaring CRISPR/CAS9 genetic scissors one of gene technology's sharpest tools. So for this discovery, they have been awarded the prize in chemistry. The CRISPR/CAS9 tool has already contributed to significant gains in crop resilience, altering their genetic code to better withstand drought and pests. The technology has contributed to new cancer therapies. Then peace. The 2020 Nobel Peace Prize has been awarded to the World Food Program, a United Nations agency, for its efforts to combat hunger, bettering conditions for peace in conflict-affected areas and preventing the use of hunger as a weapon of war and conflict. So for this contribution, World Food Program has been awarded for Peace Prize this year. So it is awarded for its work upon eradicating hunger, which is one of the UN Sustainable Development Goals. Then Economic Sciences, American economist Paul Milgrom and Robert Wilson have been awarded the Swerige's Riksbank Prize in Economic Sciences 2020 for their work on commercial actions. So first of all, let me tell you, let me clear a doubt that Economic Sciences Award is not given by Nobel Prize Trust, but it is actually given by this bank called Swerige's Riksbank Prize in Economic Sciences. It was created in 1968 by a donation from Sweden's central bank. So the name is Sveriges Riksbank to the Nobel Foundation to commemorate the bank's 300th anniversary, and it includes a prize of 10 million Swedish kronor award. Then literature, the Nobel Prize in Literature 2020 has been awarded to the USA poet Louis Gluck for an unmistakable poetic voice that with austere beauty makes individual existence universal. So for her poetic work, Louis Gluck has been awarded Nobel Prize in Literature of the year 2020. Then we will be dealing with QS World Ranking. As many as 25 courses by Indian universities have figured in the top 100 globally according to US World University Ranking. So QS World Ranking actually ranks the universities around the world. Three Indian institutes of technology have entered the prestigious group of the top 100 engineering institutes, with IIT Bombay grabbing the best ever 49th position in the engineering and technology category, followed by IIT Delhi and IIT Madras. MIT USA has retained its top position. Now NIRF ranking, if I talk about NIRF ranking, ISC Bangalore secured number 1 position in the NIRF ranking. In the Life Sciences and Medicine category, All India Institute of Medical Sciences bagged the 248th spot, and Jawaharlal Nehru has been ranked 159th for Arts and Humanities, followed by University of Delhi. It has ranked 252. Also, Delhi University back 208th spot worldwide in the Social Sciences and Management category. Then I will be dealing with Jamia Millia Islamia's World Ranking. So it has secured ranking between 751 to 800 in the world and 203rd position in Asia, according to QS World Ranking. And if I talk about Times Higher Education, then it is ranked between 601 to 800. Now I'll talk about India's World Ranking, SDR Report 2021, also known as Sustainable Development Report 2021. So in its 6th edition, India ranked 120 out of 165 countries with a country score of 60.1, and Finland topped the rankings and followed by Sweden and Denmark, later on Germany and Belgium. The Sustainable Development Report, formerly the SDG Index and Dashboard, is the first study worldwide that assesses each country based on its performance against all 17 Sustainable Development Goals. So the rankings are given according to the country's performance against all 17 Sustainable Development Goals. Then Climate Change Performance Index 2020, India has ranked 10th position. It has actually slid down from 9th position last year, and the top position holders are Sweden, and the US has ranked the last at 61st. Then Ease of Doing Business 2020, the World Bank has released its 17th annual report on Ease of Doing Business 2020 to compare business regulation in 190 economies, and India has ranked 63rd position. Then India Innovation Index, and this index is released by Niti Aayog, and Karnataka retained its position as the most innovative major state in the country, and followed by Maharashtra at second place with a score of 38, Tamil Nadu at third place, Bihar was ranked the last in the index. And if I talk about Northeast and hilly states, Himachal Pradesh topped the India Innovation Index. Then SDG India Index 2022-2021, and this index is also released by Niti Aayog. Recently, the third edition of the Sustainable Development Goals SDG India Index and Dashboard 2022-2021 was released by Niti Aayog, and the index is actually in collaboration with the United Nations in India, and the rankings are based on the state's performances on 17 Sustainable Development Goals. And these states are actually ranked on four criteria: this aspirant, performer, front runner, and achiever. So currently there are no states in the aspirant and achiever category. 15 states and UTs are in the performer category, and 22 UTs in the front runner categories. So Kerala has retained its position at the top of the front runner state rankings, followed by Tamil Nadu and Himachal Pradesh, both scoring 72. Then next is GI Tax India 2021. Like you all are aware, these kind of questions are generally asked in Jamia's current affairs section. So this is the reason why I am discussing with you the GI Tax, which were conferred on the products in the year 2020. The GI Tax is the abbreviation of the Geographical Indication Tax in India. It came into force with effect from 15 September 2003. Darjeeling tea was the first Indian product to get a GI Tax, remember that. And in 2020, chalk how the black rice of Manipur and Gorakhpur terracotta have backed the Geographical Indication Tax, followed by Kashmir saffron for its premium quality and its enticing aroma. Then Kovil Patti Kadalai Mithai has been granted the Geographical Indication Tag for the year 2020. Then we'll talk about GI Tags of 2019. Odisha Rasgulla, Rasagulla has been given the GI Tags for 2019. Then also other GI Tags like Palani Panch Mirtam in Palani Town, Tamil Nadu. Then Tall Hope Puan from Mizoram, it's actually an attire of Mizoram, and also Mizo Puan Chai from Mizoram, Thirur Betel Leaf from Kerala. So this GI Tax had been granted in the year 2019. Then we'll talk about sports. This is very important. Actually, the questions from sports are very much anticipated, or say are must or sure shot in any entrance examination, And also, if I talk about Jamia's LLM entrance examination, they generally ask question from sports section. So this is the reason why I will be dealing this section in detail. So first, what is Wimbledon Championship 2021 winners men's category? So in the main category, Novak Djokovic defeated Matteo Berrettini in the Wimbledon final to win his 6th Wimbledon title and 20th Grand Slam trophy. With this win, he has equaled his total major men's singles titles record with Roger Federer and Rafael Nadal, with each of them winning 20 titles. So he has actually equaled his records with Roger Federer, Rafael Nadal, and here Novak Djokovic has won his 6th Wimbledon title. And also Novak Djokovic has won major title Australian Open and French Open. And also he has won the Australian Open in the year 2020. So this is his straight 3 wins. Then women's category. In women's category, Ashley Barty of Australia beat Carolina Pliskova, Czech Republic, to win her first Wimbledon women's singles title on July 10, 2020. The 25-year-old Barty is the first Australian woman to win the Wimbledon singles title in 41 years since Yvonne Goolagong, who claimed her second All England club title in 1980. So she has been the second Australian woman to win this women's category Wimbledon tennis tournament. Other women's Grand Slam winner in 2021. So let us see. French Open has been won by Barbora Krejcikova. Australian Open has been won by Naomi Osaka. And if I talk about 2020 Grand Slam winner in women's category, French Open has been won by Iga Swiatek, US Open by Naomi Osaka, and Australian Open is Sofia Kenin. So this is the winner list of the last year, and this year Australian Open has been won by Naomi Osaka, and I have already told you Ashley Barty has won this year's Wimbledon Tennis Championship, and French Open has been won by Barbora Krejcikova. Then tennis Grand Slam winners of 2020, I'll talk about men. So I have already told you Australian Open has been won by Novak Djokovic, French title by Rafael Nadal, and US Open by Dominic Thiem. And this year the Wimbledon Grand Slam wasn't held. Then we'll talk about cricket. ICC Men's T20 World Cup will now be held in UAE and Oman from 17 October to 14 November 2021. So this year, ICC Men's T20 World Cup will be held in UAE and Oman. The 2023 ICC Men's Cricket World Cup will be the 13th edition of the Men's Cricket World Cup, scheduled to be hosted by India during the October and November 2023. So India is hosting the ICC Men's Cricket World Cup of the year 2023, and ICC Women's T20 World Cup will now be held in South Africa in the same year, in the year 2021. Then other sports affairs, so I'll only tell you the important ones. You can read the rest of the other tournaments by pausing this video. So India to host 2026 World Badminton Championship. In Euro final, Italy beats England on penalties. Then Portugal captain Cristiano Ronaldo wins Golden Boot in Euro 2020. 2022 Khelo India Youth Games to be held in Haryana. And Mumbai Pune to host 2022 Women's Asian Cup. So this is actually a football cup. Argentina beats Brazil to lift Copa America 2021. MC Maricom, the 6-time world boxing champion, and Manpreet Singh, the men's hockey team's keeper, will be India's flag bearers at the opening ceremony of the Tokyo Olympics, announced Indian Olympic Association Bajrang Punia. A silver medalist at the 2018 World Wrestling Championship will be the flag bearer at the closing ceremony on August 8. Then top para high jumper Mariappan Thangavelu was named the flag bearer of the Indian contingent in the Tokyo Paralympics. Max Verstappen wins Formula One's Australian Grand Prix, Austrian Grand Prix 2021. Indian origin, this one is important. Indian origin American Abhimanyu Mishra has become the youngest ever chess grandmaster in the world At 12 years, 4 months and 25 days, he obliterated the long-standing record held by Sergei Karzakin, who was 12 years and 7 months old when he attained the title. So, an Indian origin American has won the Grand Slam and who was just 12 years, 4 months and 25 days. Then FIFA Under-17 Women's World Cup to be held in India in October 2022. Samir Banerjee wins Wimbledon Junior Men's title. New Zealand defeated India to win the first ICC World Test Championship. New Zealand chased down the target of 139 to win the first ever World Test Championship final with 8 wickets in hand. Kylie Jamieson, New Zealand, has been adjusted as the player of the month, while Kane Williamson is the player of the series. Then Indian captain Mithali Raj became the highest run getter in Women's World Cup across formats, overtaking former England skipper Charlotte Edwards. India's Rahi Sarnobat clinched the gold medal in the Women's 25-meter pistol event at the ISSF Shooting World Cup. India's ace shuttler PV Sindhu has won a silver medal in the BWF Swiss Open Super 300 in the final of the women's singles event held at Basel, Switzerland. This one is important. Bhavani Devi became the first ever Indian fencer to qualify for the Olympics. Then Sunil Chhetri surpasses Argentina's Lionel Messi and he has become the second highest active international gold scorer with 74 strikes. He made the record in a joint preliminary qualifying round match for the 2022 FIFA World Cup and 2023 Asian Cup. In hockey, Indian men's team maintained their fourth position while women's hockey team held to the ninth position in the latest International Hockey Federation World Rankings. A new song has been released for Tokyo Olympics titled Hindustani Way and it has been composed by A.R. Rahman and Ananya Billa. Then Royal Challengers Bangalore, who have found themselves on the receiving end, finally got their hands on the coveted Indian Premier League silverware. So this year RCB Bangalore has won the IPL final. And this was made possible by a RCB fan and Reddit user Adit Jain, who ran a simulation script to find the IPL 2021 winner. So this year, the winner of IPL has been chosen by a simulation script and it had been made possible by RCB fan and a Reddit user. Rani Rampal, Manpreet Singh named captains of Indian hockey teams. Then Indian wrestler Vinesh Fogart won the gold medal in the 53 kg category at the Poland. Virat Kohli became the fastest to reach 12,000 runs in one-day international cricket. Kohli breached the mark in the third ODI against Australia in Canberra. So remember this, Kohli has become the fastest to reach 12,000 and he has also, by this he has broken the record set by Sachin Tendulkar. In which he has actually Kohli has achieved this milestone in his 242nd innings, but Tendulkar has actually reached 12,000 runs in 300 innings. Then other sports current affairs of the year 2020, former India captain and member of the 1983 World Cup winning team Krishnamachari Srikanth was awarded this year year's prestigious C.K. Naidu Lifetime Award. Former India women's captain Anjum Chopra is the co-recipient of the Lifetime Achievement Award for the year 2019. So both Srikanth and Anjum Chopra won the 2020's C.K. Naidu Lifetime Achievement Award. The BCCI has announced that Jasprit Bumrah will receive the prestigious Pauli Umrigar Award for his super performance in international cricket in the session 2018-2019. Kuldeep Yadav became the fastest Indian spinner to claim 100 wickets in ODI during the second match against Australia in Rajkot. And he is a left-arm spinner and he has reached this milestone in his 58th match. Earlier, this record has been held by Harbhajan Singh, who has achieved this feat in 76 matches. Then we'll talk about international events. World Environment Day which is celebrated on June 5. So this the theme of this year's World Environment Day is ecosystem restoration. Pakistan will act as global host of the day. World Environment Day 2021 will see the launch of the UN Decade on Ecosystem Restoration, Earth Day. So Earth Day every year is celebrated on April 22nd, and this year the theme was Restore Our Earth. Then COP26, very important. So these are the conferences and conventions which are very important in environmental law. UK will host the 26th UN Climate Change Conference of the Parties, COP26, in Glasgow on 31st of October to 12th November 2021. COP26 is the next annual UN Climate Change Conference. COP stands for Conference at the Parties, and summit will be attended by countries that signed the UNFCCC on Climate Change Treaty that came into force in 1994. So COP26 is nothing but an annual UN Climate Change Conference, and it is attended by the parties that have signed United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, a treaty which came into force in 1994. Then we'll talk about books and authors, again very important topic. A book titled The Great Big Lion, drawn and written by child prodigy Chrissie Knight. This book is a story about a lion and two children. So this book has been written by child prodigy Chrissie Knight. Chief Justice of India, Justice N.V. Ramana, has released former Supreme Court Judge R.V. Ravindra's book, Anomalies in Law and Justice. So the name of the book is Anomalies in Law and Justice, and the author of the book is R.V. Ravindra. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has received the first copy of the Ramayana of Sri Guru Gobind Singh Ji, which is written by the late Baljit Kaur Tulsi. And she is the mother of noted lawyer K.T.S. Tulsi. A new book titled The Light of Asia, authored by Jairam Ramesh, is a biography of an epic bio poem on the Buddha. Then Kareena Kapoor Khan has announced her new book titled Kareena Kapoor Khan's Pregnancy Bible. Then Union Health Minister Harshvardhan has unveiled Krishna Saxena's books My Joys and Sorrows as a mother of a special child. Suresh Raina has released his autobiography, and the name of the autobiography is Believe What Life and Cricket Taught Me. Jnanpith awardee and renowned author Amitabh Ghosh authored a book titled The Nutmeg's Curse, Parables for a Planet in Crisis. Then Amartya Sen has also penned down a book which is actually his memoir, and the name of the book is Home in the World. J.K. Rowling has a new book comic this autumn. And the name of the book is The Christmas Peak, is Rowling's first children novel since Harry Potter. So this book has been released in the year 2020. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has paid tributes to India's first law minister and the architect of the Indian Constitution, Babasaheb Bhimrao Ambedkar, on his birth anniversary, and released four books based on his life written by Kishore Makhwana. Then Vice President Venkaiah Naidu has released a book, Supari Palana, by retired civil servant Dr. Shailendra Joshi. And these are the books which has been released in the year 2020. Home Minister Amit Shah has released a book, Rashtra Pratham, 82 Varsho Ki Swarnim Gatha, in New Delhi. The book chronicles the glorious history of CRPF since its raising in 1939. By Many a Happy Accident, Recollections of a Life. This is authored by M. Hamid Ansari. Tibetan spiritual leader Dalai Lama has also penned down a book, and it is titled The Little Book of Encouragement. Ramchandra Guha's latest book, the name of the book is The Commonwealth of Cricket, a coffee table book named Modi India Calling 2021, and this has been released on the occasion of 16th Bharatiya Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. And the book is actually contains various photographs of Prime Minister Narendra Modi captured during his 107 overseas and bilateral visits. So these are picture book actually. Actor Priyanka Chopra Jonas memoir named Unfinished. Renowned American author Jhumpa Lahiri has launched her new novel titled Whereabouts. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will release the Hindi translation of the book Odisha Itihas, written by Utkal Kesari Hare Krishna Mehtab, on 9th April at the Ambedkar International Center. This book has already been released, and the most famous book of Narendra Modi is Exam Warriors. So a new updated version has been launched. Now will talk about books and authors of 2020. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has released a book on the life and ideals of Guru Nanak Dev, the founder of Sikhism and its first of his 10 Guru. The book has been penned by Kripal Singh Ji. Sonu Sood's book titled I Am No Masiha, and this book has been penned, co-authored by Meena Iyer. The book will account the experience of Sonu Sood during the COVID-19 pandemic. Renowned author and politician Shashi Tharoor is set to release his new book titled The Battle of Belonging. So this book has been written by Mr. Shashi Tharoor. Veteran economist and bureaucrat N.K. Singh, he is also the chairman of 15th Finance Commission. He has released his autobiography titled Portraits of Power, Half a Century of Being at Ringside. A new book titled Azadi, authored by Arundhati Roy. Pope Francis is set to release the book. So this book, Let Us Dream, has been written by Pope Francis and it is set to release. So now we'll talk about films and awards. We'll start with BAFTA Award 2021. BAFTA, known as British Academy Film Awards for the year 2021, has been announced by the British Academy of Film and Television Arts. BAFTA 2021 is the 74th edition of the annual award to honor the best national and foreign films of 2020 and early 2021. So this has been the 74th edition of BAFTA Film Awards. The list of winners: the best film is Nomadland, best director is Kloja for Nomadland, best actor in a leading role is Anthony Hopkins, the father is Anthony, best actress in a leading role is Frances McDormand for her film The Nomadland as Fern. The 93rd Academy Awards 2021, also known as Oscar Awards, and in this award also The Nomadland has been chosen the best film in the 93rd Academy Awards, and Frances McDormand wins third best actress honor. That is this is the third best actress award given to Frances McDormand. That means she is winning it for the third time. Best actor again Anthony Hopkins for the film called The Father, and best director is Chloe Zhao for her film Nomadland. So Nomadland has been overall the biggest winner in both the award functions. Dada Saheb Phalke Award. So this year the 51st Dada Saheb Phalke Award will be given to, and it's conferred on superstar Rajinikanth. Then 67th National Film Awards. The 67th National Film Awards were announced on Monday evening in New Delhi with the honors for films for the year 2019. So the film award has been given for the films which has been released in the year 2019. Director Priyadarshan's Malayalam war epic Marakkar, Lion of the Arabian Sea, that is headlined by Mohanlal, won best feature film. One Malayalam movie called Marakkar, Lion of the Arabian Sea has won the best feature film award. The best acting honors went to Manoj Bajpayee for Bhosle, Dhanush for Tamil film Asuran, and Kangana Ranaut for two of her films Panga and Manikarnika, the Queen of Jhansi. Vijay Sethupathi for his film Super Deluxe, and Pallavi Joshi for her film The Tashkent Files won the Supporting Actor Awards, while the Best Director Award has been given to Sanjay Puran Singh Chauhan for his film Behtar Hure. Awards and Honours 2021. Now we'll see the awards and honours of the year 2021. P. Sainath is a journalist and he has won Japan's Fukuoka Grand Prize 2021. Deepika Kumari is an Indian archer and she has won a gold medal at Archery World Cup Stage 3, which was held in Paris. So I'll only read the important ones, and the rest of the other awards and honors you can read by your own by pausing the video. K.K. Shalja, Central European University's highest award of Open Society Prize 2021 for her work in public health services. So K.K. Shalja was the health minister, the former health minister of the state of Karnataka. David Duke has won the International Booker Prize 2021 for At Night All Blood is Black. R.K. Sabharwal, he is actually the CMD of Engineers India Limited, and he has been awarded the highest civilian award of Mongolia known as the Order of Polar Star. Shyamala Ganesh, She was awarded the Order of Rising Sun by the Japanese government. She is a Japanese language teacher. And Sharan Kumar Limbale, he is of Marathi writer and he will be honored with Saraswati Samman 2020. Babar Azam Pakistan, he has chosen the ICC Men's Player of the Month for April 2021. And Ravichandran Ashwin has earlier won the ICC Men's Player of the Month for February 2021. Konedu Hampi has won the BBC Indian Sportsman of the Year Award. Anju Bobby George is an Indian athlete. She has won the BBC Lifetime Achievement Award. And Manu Bhakar, Indian shooter, she has won the BBC Emerging Player of the Year Award. Then Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank, he is honored with Sahitya Gaurav Samman 2021 by Hindi Writers Guild of Canada. Ministry of Tribal Affairs and Minister Panchayati Raj has won the Scotch Challenger Award for Best Performance in E-Governance and for Transparency in Governance category respectively. And this year's Best Avenue has been won by Uttar Pradesh for its Avenue or based on Ayodhya Cultural Heritage of Uttar Pradesh. Then we did with Padma Awards. So Padma Awards is generally conferred, these awards are conferred before the eve of Republic Day. So let us see. So Padma Vibhushan, Mr. Shinzo Abe, who was the Prime Minister of Japan, won the Padma Vibhushan in the field of public affairs. Then Shri S.P. Balasubramaniam, he was a noted musician and singer and he was conferred the Padma Vibhushan in art from Tamil Nadu. Then there are other persons also, like Dr. Bele Monappa Hegre from Karnataka has won in the field of medicine. Then we'll deal with Padma Bhushan. So in Padma Bhushan's category, Shri Tarun Gogoi posthumously has been awarded in public affairs from Assam. Then Miss Sumitra Mahajan, again in public affairs from Madhya Pradesh. And Shri Nipendra Mishra has been awarded Padma Bhushan in civil service Uttar Pradesh. And lastly, Ram Vilas Paswan has won posthumously the Padma Bhushan Award in public affairs from the state of Bihar. Gallantry Awards 2021. So we'll see, because I have seen the Jamia Millia Islamia's previous question papers in which they have already asked questions on gallantry awards like Mahavir Chakra or Veer Chakra awardee. So let us see. Mahavir Chakra was awarded to Colonel Bikumalla Santosh Babu from Bihar Regiment. Veer Chakra was awarded to Naib Sub Nuduram Soren. And also Havaldar Tejinder Singh, then Sipahi Gurtej Singh posthumously. So these persons have been awarded Veer Chakra posthumously. Kirti Chakra was awarded to Subedar Sanjeev Kumar. Shaurya Chakra was awarded to Major Anuj Sood posthumously. RFN Pranab Jyoti Das and PTR Sonam Shering Tamang. Appointments. Now we'll deal with the most important section, which is the appointments. So sports and appointments both are very important topics for any current affairs section of entrance examination. So we'll see appointments. Joe Biden becomes 46th president of the US, and Kamala Harris of Indian origin has been chosen the vice president of the US. T.V. Narendran, he was appointed as President of Confederation of Indian Industry. He is MD and CEO of Tata Steel. Isaac Herzog, he was appointed as President of Israel. He has replaced Reuven Rivlin. So earlier Reuven Rivlin was the President of Israel. Vice Admiral Ravneet Singh, he was appointed as Deputy Chief of Naval Staff. The Chief of Naval Staff is Admiral Karamveer Singh presently. Justice A.K. Mishra has been appointed as the Chairperson of the National Human Rights Commission. Then Justice Vikramjit Sen, he has been appointed as the Chairman of the Digital Media Content Regulatory Council by the Indian Broadcasting Foundation. Then Dr. Patrick Amoth, he was appointed as Chairman of the WHO Executive Board. He is the acting director of the Health Ministry of Kenya. Then Paresh Bilal, so he was appointed as grievance officer for India by WhatsApp. So this is important. So this person has been appointed as grievance officer for India by WhatsApp. Abdullah Shahid, he was appointed as president of the 76th session of the United Nations General Assembly. And by this, he has replaced 75th president. This is Volkan Bozkir from Turkey. Anup Chandra Pandey, again very important one. He was appointed as election commissioner by Union Government for the tenure of 3 years. He has replaced Sunil Arora. Then Secretary General Antonio Guterres has been approved for the second time chief of the United Nations Security Council. He has been approved as the second time to hold the position of UN chief by United Nations Security Council. Satya Nadella, Microsoft Corporation appointed CEO Satya Nadella to be their chairman, and he has replaced John Thompson. Then Naftali Bennett, he has been appointed as the 13th Prime Minister of Israel. He has replaced Benjamin Netanyahu. Hardliner Ibrahim Raisi is said to become Iran's president, so he will be the new president replacing Hassan Rouhani. And he was actually the head of Iran's judiciary. Sureshan Patel was appointed as acting Central Vigilance Commissioner, and he will be replacing Sanjay Kothari. So Sanjay Kothari was the earlier chairman of Central Vigilance Commissioner. Now Sureshan Patel has been appointed as acting. Karnam Maleshwari, she was appointed as first Vice Chancellor of Delhi Sports University. She is a former Olympic medalist weightlifter. Then Sheikh Nawab Al Ahmad Al Zabar Al Sabah, he is the Crown Prince of Kuwait and is sworn in as new Emir of Kuwait. He has replaced Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmad Al Zabar Al Sabah. So the name of the new Sheikh is Sheikh Nawab. Luis Ecar will be appointed as President of Bolivia. So let us see the other static part of Bolivia. So the capital of Bolivia is Sucre or La Paz. And the currency of Bolivia is Boliviano. Then Wavell Rama Kalvan, he is appointed as president of Seychelles. And the static part, like the capital of Seychelles is Victoria, and the currency of Seychelles is Seychelles rupee. Alpha Conde, he is appointed as president of Guinea for third time. The capital of Guinea is Conakry, and the currency of Guinea is Guinean franc. Yashwardhan K. Sinha is appointed as Chief Information Commissioner of India. So Yashwardhan Sinha is a new Chief Information Commissioner. Rohan Jaitley, he is elected unopposed as the President of Delhi and District Cricket Association. Jacinda Ardern, she is re-elected as Prime Minister of New Zealand for a second consecutive 3-year term. The static part, the capital of New Zealand is Wellington, and the currency is New Zealand dollar. Asad Al Hariri, he is reappointed as Prime Minister of Lebanon. The capital of Lebanon is Beirut, and currency of Lebanon is Lebanese pound. So now we'll see Bashar Hafez Al Assad. He was re-elected to be the President of Syria for the fourth term. So this person has been re-elected to be the President of Syria for the fourth time. And let us see the other static part. The capital of Syria is Damascus, and the currency of Syria is Syrian pound. Squadron leader Ashrita V. Oleti, she has become the first female flight test engineer in the Indian Air Force. Let us see the other important static part. Air Chief Marshal Rakesh Kumar Singh Bhaduria is the Air Chief Marshal presently. Then Pramod Chandra Modi, he is reappointed as chairman of the Central Board of Direct Taxes. Thomas Bach, he is re-elected as president of the International Olympic Committee for a tenure of 4 years. Static part, the headquarter of IOC, Indian Olympic Committee, is in Lausanne in Switzerland. Aisha Aziz, she is 25 years old, hails from Kashmir, and has become India's youngest female pilot. Then Dr. Tamilsai Soundarajan, she is appointed as an additional charge of Lieutenant Governor of Puducherry, and she has replaced Dr. Kiran Bedi. She is also serving as Governor of Telangana. Then Hima Das, she is appointed as Deputy Superintendent of Police by Assam Government. Let us see the other static part. The CM of Assam is Sarbananda Sonowal and the Governor of Assam is Professor Jagdish Mukhi. Ajay Mathur, he is appointed as Director General of International Solar Alliance. He has replaced Upendra Tripathi. Preeti Sinha, she is appointed as Executive Secretary of the United Nations Capital Development Fund, UNCDF, and she has replaced Judith Kahl. The other static part, the headquarter of United Nations Capital Development Fund is it at New York. Then Gozi Okonjo-Iweala, she is appointed as Director General of the World Trade Organization. She has replaced Roberto Azevedo. This is very important. The static part, headquarter of World Trade Organization is at Geneva, Switzerland. Then Apurva Chandra, he is appointed as Chairperson of Governing Body of International Labour Organization. Currently, he is serving as Secretary, Labour and Employment under Ministry of Labour and Employment. Static part, the headquarter of ILO is at Geneva, Switzerland. The Director General of ILO is Guy Ryder. And Union Minister for State for Labour Employment is Santosh Kumar Gangwar. So, there has been some change. So, let's ignore it. Lieutenant General Chandi Prasad Mohanty, and he is appointed as Vice Chief of Army Staff. He has replaced Lieutenant General S.K. Saini. Japarov Sadir Nurgojovich, he was selected as President of Kyrgyzstan. So let us see the other static part. The capital of Kyrgyzstan is Bishkek and the currency of Kyrgyzstan is Kyrgyzstani som. Bhavya Lal, she is appointed as Acting Chief of Staff of NASA. Henry Moniz, he is appointed as the first Chief Compliance Officer of Facebook. Mario Draghi, he is sworn in as Prime Minister of Italy. He has replaced Giuseppe Conte. So the new Prime Minister of Italy is Mario Draghi. We have already dealt with this here, like the Hima Das has been appointed as Deputy Superintendent of Police by Assam. Then Kaja Kallas, she is appointed as the first female Prime Minister of Estonia. She has replaced Judy Ratas. Let us see the other static part. Capital of Estonia is Tallinn and the currency of Estonia is Euro. Shisiko Hashimoto, she is appointed as Tokyo Olympic President. She has replaced Yoshiro Mori. Ajay Malhotra, he has become the first Indian to be appointed as Chairperson of the United Nations Advisory Committee of the Human Rights Council, and the headquarter of Human Rights Council is at Geneva, Switzerland. Abdul Hamid Dibia, he is appointed as Interim Prime Minister of Libya. The static part, capital of Libya is Tripoli and the currency of Libya is Libyan dinar. Sher Bahadur Duba, leader of the Nepali Congress, is the new Prime Minister of Nepal. The 75-year-old centrist politician was sworn to office by President Vidya Devi Bhandari on Tuesday evening. A day after the Supreme Court of Nepal, in a dramatic verdict, said Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli had violated the constitutional principles. So, Mr. Sher Bahadur Duba has actually replaced the former Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli after the Supreme Court verdict. So, this has been the end of the session. So, the rest of the other important current affairs, I will be dealing with you in the next session. So do not forget to give a like, share, subscribe to the channel. Till we meet the next time, thank you and have a nice day.